Hi guys, today I'm going to show you a demo on our carpooling application Share on the Go. Share on the Go is a carpooling or ride sharing solution that enables users to book or offer ride for primarily three reasons: to reduce the cost, to socialize on the go, and to be fuel efficient, thus being easy on the environment. If you're looking to start a carpooling business, a ride sharing application is the way to go. Contact us on the details below for more information. We provide the complete white labeled application along with the customizations as per your requests. So let's go ahead with the application. Now let us go ahead with the demo of the application. This will be the welcome screen that you see when you open the application. The next is the tutorial screen that explains about the working of the app. On the third screen, you can find a button below that will redirect you to the home screen. This is the home screen. Here, the users can offer a ride or find a ride. Apart from offering a ride or finding a ride, they will be able to view the rides, search, offer, and profile. When the user wants to offer a ride, he would be able to tap on offer a ride. Here, the application will be asking the user for his destination. Say for example, we are going to Bangalore. Tap on continue to continue on the app. Where are you leaving from? This will be the source. Say Chennai. If you are willing to pick up passengers on the way, you can add a few stopovers here. The more stopovers you add, the more passengers you are likely to pick. I am going to add a stopover here. Say Hosur, Tamil Nadu, India. So, if you want to add more stopovers, you can do it here or press continue. When are you going? This is the date of your travel. Say 12th. Now you can pick your time from the calendar. So 2:30. Okay, next is the middle seat empty. Now if you want your passengers to be comfortable on the journey, you can set the middle seat empty. By doing so, the total number of people accommodated in the back seat will be reduced to 2. So I'm pressing confirm here. So this is going to be the number of passengers that the driver is willing to take. If I press and continue, I can move to the next screen. The next screen is the auto booking feature. Now each time a passenger requests for a ride, the driver is supposed to confirm. He would be able to enable the auto booking feature and would not be required to confirm the ride each time the passenger requests for the ride. So if I click on yes sure, I would be able to approve it automatically. On this screen, you can view the price of the total ride. That is from Chennai to Bangalore, the price is 3,480. If I click on continue, I can move ahead with the price. And if I'm not okay with the price, I can click on I don't agree. Once I click on I don't agree, I will be able to edit the amount. On this screen, as you can see, you will be able to see the price distribution along the stopover. So from Chennai to Bangalore, the price is 3,480. The price from Chennai to Hosur is 3,090. And the price from Hosur to Bangalore is 390. I can edit or delete the amount. If I'm okay with the price, I will click on continue. Now on this screen, you would be able to go for a round trip. And if I click on yes sure, the application will ask me the date of my return. I'm going to give 15th as the date of the return. And the time 12 o'clock. So I'm going to start my journey at 12 o'clock. On this screen, I would be able to add a personal message to the passengers. For example, if I don't want any pets in my car, I can give the message as no pets allowed. And post my ride. before posting my ride, I would be required to log in on the application if I haven't. So the application asks for the registered email address. As I've already registered with this email address on the application, I would be entering it here. Password, I'll be entering it here. Click on login, I would be able to post my ride. Now you can see on the screen that the ride has been published successfully. So you can see, like, congratulations, your ride has been published. If I want to see my ride offers, I can click here. On clicking the button, we will be moved to the ride screen where I can see the current and the history. The current rides consist of my offered rides, and these are ordered in the list of upcoming dates. And the history consists of all the completed rides. So this is it about offering a ride. Now let's move to finding a ride.
Alright, now let's move to find a ride. When a passenger comes on the app to find a ride, he would be able to do that by clicking on find a ride. Now on this page, as you can see, there's a departure city, and there's going to the travel date, the leaving time, and the number of seats, and the option to find a ride. So let's start with the departure city. As you already know that we had earlier given, we had offered a ride from Chennai to Bangalore, and there was a ride round trip from Bangalore back to Chennai. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to give departure city as Bangalore here. So let's type Bangalore, Karnataka, India, going to Chennai. Travel date as 15th, as we had given earlier. The leaving time as 11:30 a.m. Since the ride was created for 12 p.m., I have given the travel time as 11:30 a.m. and the number of seats is 1. And I'm going to find a ride here. Once I click on find a ride, I can see a list of rides that are available for selection. Now the first one is the latest one, that is 15. The details are given here, like for 15 January 2018. The time of departure would be 12 p.m. from Bangalore to Chennai, and the price is given as 780 rupees here, and the driver's name is John Xavier, and the deal is a good deal, and so the best deal comes on top. And when I click on this, I can see the ride summary here. The ride summary shows that the trip starts at 12 p.m. from Bangalore to Chennai, and there's one seat available, and price per seat is 780 rupees, and the message shows no pets allowed. This was the message that we were given at the time of offering the ride. The kilometers given as 348 kilometers, and the time of the travel is 6 hours 31 minutes. Now, since we had enabled the middle seat empty feature, here it's written as maximum 2 people in the back seats. So I'm going to click on book to confirm the ride. In order to book, again the application asks me how many number of seats I want to book. So I'm just going for 1, and I accept the terms and conditions and privacy policy. I click book. Now this is the summary. Since it's just one seat that I'm going to book, the price is 780 rupees. And the car owner's name is shown in the profile picture, and that is from Bangalore to Chennai. And I'm going to click on continue to continue booking. Now before completing the booking, the application asks me to log in with my registered email address and password. So I'm going to enter the email address here. Successfully logged in to the application, and I can continue to finish booking. So it shows that the ride has been booked. Now you have to note here that since we had enabled the auto booking feature at the time of offering the ride, the confirmation is instantly done. And otherwise, in other cases, if you do not enable the auto booking feature at the time of offering the ride, the ride request is sent to the driver for approval, and once approved, and the booking is confirmed. So that is it. And here you can see the current rides. This is the list of bookings, and you can see another tab, that is the history tab. This is the offered rides and the bookings is the latest one first, moving to the farthest. This is the most recent booking shown here that we've just booked, the ride which we've just done. And you can see that there are alternatively more navigation tabs here. One is for search, this is find a ride, this is for offering a ride. Then you have the inbox that consists of the messages from between the car owners and the passengers. And then there's notifications, which are the in-app notifications which are received. And then there's the user profile. This consists of the user details. You can write a mini bio. And this is verification section where mobile is not yet verified. So it is shown as mobile not verified. And the email address is already verified. And then this account where you can see preferences, notification preferences, the change password, and some of the CMS pages, that CMS screens like health, terms and conditions, privacy policy, and licenses. So, and on the account, as you can see, there's a logout button here. And this is it. So thank you guys, and have a nice day.